Can you tell us more about your professional journey in the automotive industry?
Yeah, it was quite a journey. You're right. As a profession, I am an aerospace engineer. That's my first degree. And after that, I was having another one, another university for business and economic editor. These two was giving me the opportunity to understand deeply both the technical side of the car industry, of all the new models, all the new technologies, but also the industry by itself in terms of financials, in terms of the way it's organized, how big can be, and so on. With this background, I managed to understand more and more what is going on. I learned, and in these last 30 years, I made a lot of things, including AutoPro, which was the first car magazine in Romania after the Berlin Wall falling, or as we call it here in my own country, after the revolution. I was founding the first motor show in Romania together with some other guys. I was founding the Romanian Car of the Year, the Motoring Press Association. And in the meantime, I was founding a lot of other magazines. Some of them I sold, which made me the first in the region who sold ever in the car industry something to Germans, because my magazine Auto Show was bought by Burda Germany, which back then was kind of a premier. But definitely, it's important to say that I was working like hell to make people understand the car industry, make people understand not necessarily what happened in the past, but mainly what is going on in the future. Because nowadays, we are all living in a disruptive industry, in a disruptive time, and it's more and more difficult to understand what is coming, how you will be better prepared for the future. Look to a simple thing. 5 years ago, 10 years ago, when someone was buying a car, was pretty sure about the future of this, pretty sure about the residual value, pretty sure how much money you can get after 3 years or 5 years. Today is not so easy. Even the biggest companies for evaluation cars in Europe are facing quite a dramatic shift. They try to understand how they can have a real evaluation, because days with these trends I defined more than 6 years ago as a premier in Europe, these mega trends, which are green technologies, autonomous, connected technologies, and ride sharing. With these trends, today a car could be fantastic, but in 2 years to be obsolete. Of course, it's dramatic, sounds dramatic, but if you look to the latest years, how the things are developing in our industry, if you look to the electrification process, you can see that it's dramatic, but it's also real.